До вас прийшло СБУ.
Hey there. Ukraine's God service here for you.
Боже України.
Євген Савченко has been a pastor at the Nadia Evangelical Baptist Church in his native city of Rubizhne in the Luhansk region for nearly 30 years. The 50-year-old father of eight has also been going to the front lines to help Ukrainian fighters since 2017. He says he unofficially performed chaplain duties for 7 years. Then in 2023, he officially signed on as a military chaplain with Ukraine's armed forces.
I meet our warriors, our soldiers, and I got to say, I have love for them as fighters, as people who really give their all.
He also visits the wounded.
Thank you, Lord, for your mercy. Oh Lord, help him heal and give him the strength to recover quickly.
Serving as a military chaplain is new in the Ukrainian armed forces. In November 2021, the Ukrainian parliament adopted the law which is similar to one in other NATO countries. It is not about any specific faith, Savchenko says, but just being there for the soldiers.
I see chaplaincy as an example of tolerance, an example of brotherhood. And indeed, they are chaplains belonging to different denominations, different religions, Muslims, for example. But we all understand each other and agree with each other.
And it's not just about providing spiritual healing. For instance, this mobile bathhouse for Ukrainian fighters in the Donbas region was Savchenko's idea.
The biggest reward for me was to see our boys to use the bathhouse, then come out and say, feels like I've visited home.
The mobile bathhouse can accommodate up to 5 people at the same time. But it's not just a chance for soldiers to bathe. It also has washing machines they can use.
I really like the bathhouse. It is so hot that I took a steam bath and will be back tomorrow. I'll also give a few things a wash.
Савченко says it's not a job you can do part-time.
It means sacrificing your family life and everyday life. It means leaving your home and staying with your brigade the whole time. And sadly, not all priests can follow this path.
Савченко's family, including all his 8 children, is waiting for him at home. His oldest son, who is just 20, is already following in his father's footsteps and volunteers at the front lines as a chaplain's aide. Anna Kostyuchenko for VOA News, Donetsk region, Ukraine.